friends, welcome to my channel. Hope everyone is at home and safe. So today I will be talking about a small instrument which I believe should be a part of each household. So the instrument I am talking about is this, a TDS meter. So before I show you what is TDS meter and how it works, let's find out what is TDS.
So what is TDS? So TDS here doesn't mean the income tax TDS. So TDS here means total dissolved solids, and it represents the concentration of dissolved substance in water. So TDS mainly made up of inorganic salts as well as small amount of organic matter. The common inorganic salts that can be found in water includes calcium, magnesium, potassium, sodium, which are called cations, and carbonates, nitrates, bicarbonates, which are known as anions. So that brings us to the next question. How do these solids end up dissolved in water? So this can be originated from number of sources, both natural and result of human activities. Natural includes mineral springs, carbonate deposits, salt deposits, and seawater intrusion. These minerals can also come from human activities, agriculture, urban runoff, carry excess minerals into water resources, the wastewater ditches, the industrial wastewater, also the chemicals used in drinking water treatment. All this results adding solids in water. So why TDS is important in terms of drinking water? A high concentration of dissolved solids is usually not a health hazard. In fact, we buy mineral water which has naturally elevated levels of dissolved solids. But a high concentration of TDS is also an indicator of harmful contaminants, including aluminium, lead, arsenic, mercury, which are really dangerous to health and may cause cancer. So high level of dissolved solids also have technical effects. These solids produce hot water, which leaves deposits flames on fixtures, also on the insides of hot water pipes and boilers. Soaps detergent does not produce lather with hard water as with soft water. It corrodes pipes. Hard water causes water filters to wear out sooner. So what should be the preferable level of TDS in water? Though we need minerals in our body, but there is a limit to everything. WHO came with the following conclusion about the preferable level. A TDS level between 50 to 150 ppm is considered excellent for drinking purpose. Between 150 to 300 it's good. Between 300 to 500 it's poor. Between 500 to 1200 it's not at all recommended. You better get a RO water purifier. Above 1200 it's unacceptable. It's not fit for drinking at all. So the big question, what is TDS meter and why do we need it? So after gathering information about TDS, we now know how much it is important for us. So the TDS meter helps first to measure the salt content of our drinking and household water. Second, it helps to determine which water purifier will best suits our water. A TDS level greater than 500 ppm generally indicates you need a RO-based water purifier. A TDS level below 150 ppm, you can safely go for a gravity-based water purifier.
So now that we have known what is TDS and its impact in our drinking water, so let's have a quick demo where I will show you how to measure the TDS level of water with this instrument. So as I am based in Bangalore, we have a recovery water connection at home. We use this water to wash utensils and vegetables, but for drinking purpose we use a can water. So I will compare tap water and can water for the TDS level comparison. So let's have some tap water in a glass. So I will take some drinking water in another glass. So we have two types of water now. The left hand side is the tap water and the right hand side is the drinking water. So I will use this TDS meter to check the TDS level of each water. So there are three buttons in the TDS meter. The first one is on and off. The second one is to check the temperature. And the third one is hold. So I will first on the TDS meter. So you can see the readings are zero. So if I press the temperature button, you can see it gives the temperature of the day. So it's 28 right now in Bangalore. So let me restart the meter and I will now check the TDS level of each water. So let's first test the tap water. So you can see the readings is 124. Now I will reset the meter again and we'll insert into our drinking water. So you can see the readings are around 90. So you can see now the TDS level of each water is different. So that means the TDS meter is working perfectly. Also we saw the TDS level it's below 150 mark, which is considered to be an excellent for drinking purpose. So today we learned what is TDS and the importance of TDS in our drinking water. Also we learned how to measure the TDS level of water. Hope you like the video and is useful for you. So do like, share, comment for any queries. Until next time, bye bye.